enable.
Welcome to Season 6 of NSE FinWiz, powered by CNBC TV 18. I'm Mridu Bhandari, and in Season 6 of the series, we're exploring the theme, Invest in Yourself, Your Path to Prosperity. Today in New Delhi, we are at Tiger Logistics, an integrated logistics provider that has clients around the world, and we are all set to host a financial literacy workshop for the company's employees.
Founded in 2000 in New Delhi with just 8 employees, Tiger Logistics India has been committed to deliver cost-effective, error-free, timely and superior logistics solutions to clients all over India. Understanding the global language of supply chain management, hundreds of skilled professionals provide integrated logistics solutions to clients across a diverse range of industry verticals, such as construction, infrastructure, automobile, aviation, defense, energy, telecom, healthcare, and many more. Despite a challenging environment in Indian logistics sector, Tiger Logistics today is listed on the Bombay Stock Exchange, thereby becoming the 9th Indian logistics company to go public. This week, NSE FinWiz is at Tiger Logistics in Delhi to engage with young minds assembled there on the theme, Invest in Yourself, Your Path to Prosperity.
It's a great opportunity for all of us. It's a great opportunity for my staff, especially, you know, we've got a young team, and of course, we always look forward to their, well-being. So it is a great opportunity for all my staff who would know what are the new methods of financial saving today available.
It is good that since we have a very good team, a large team, right from a middle order, low level to the senior levels. With this workshop on the investment and everything, it will be good to understand what all investment or which all opportunities we have to make the investment and to have much more return, better returns from the traditional returns what we are doing till yet.
I would like to know what all it can help me for my retirement stage, what all investment I should do, what all doubts which we have will be sorted out as far as this session goes.
I think anybody who is giving you the person who is an expert and giving you and teaching you something. So I think that's the best knowledge you are getting, and accordingly you can put forward your steps and save your money.
Welcome to Season 6 of NSE FinWiz, powered by CNBC TV 18. Today we are at Tiger Logistics in New Delhi, and our set of financial experts is here to share money mantras with the employees of Tiger Logistics. So let's welcome our experts, Tanveer Alam, CEO of FinCart, Nikhil Kothari, Director and Chief Financial Planner at Etika Wealth Advisors. Welcome, Tanveer, and welcome, Nikhil. Invest in yourself, your path to prosperity. That's the theme we are following this year. So I'm going to begin by asking you, Nikhil, perhaps to share some tips on how does one define prosperity when it comes to financial wealth, short-term prosperity, long-term prosperity, and what sort of life goals should you be linking with that?
We have all financial goals. When we earn money, we are saving money to have that something we can achieve in future. So write down first, what are financial goals in your life? It can be short term, it can be medium term, it can be long term. Short term can be buying a car, going for education. Medium term can be buying a house, and long term can be for kids' education. And most important goal for all of us is our own retirement, right? So these are all financial goals what we have. And if we are able to save money and invest in such way that if we can achieve all these goals in our life, then we all will live independent a financial life. And we all live with financial freedom. And that's what we all working for. So we don't want to become a slave of money. We want to make sure that our money works for us and all our financial goals are achieved with that money.
Right. And to make that money work for us, what are the various paths that we can be taking, Tanveer? While Nikhil has spoken of short-term goals as well as long-term goals, what are the different routes that we can take for short-term prosperity as well as long-term prosperity?
Okay, let me use an anecdote to really explain to this. In fact, if you were supposed to go from here to, say, Gurgaon, how would you go? You'll take either two-wheeler vehicle, car, or metro, right? If you're going from here to, say, Mumbai, you'll use a an airplane or a train. From here to London, most likely airplane. You know, some crazy guy would want to cycle to London also. But would that be efficient? The answer is clearly no. That wouldn't be inefficient. It'll be take years to reach there. So similarly, if you're using a product like a fixed deposit to manage your long-term goals, is trying to cycle down to your retirement goal or a long-term objective, which may not be suitable. So for a long-term goals, your equity fund is suitable. Now let us take the YC verse example. Even if you're the richest man on earth, and if you want to land from here to your next Kirana shop, or you get sick and you want to land on Apollo Hospital, will you take a private plane there? The answer is no, it would be fatal, right? So even for short-term goals, then if you use equity, that could be fatal. So the best way to actually choose goal is using these anecdotes. For your short-term goals, you need to use a two-wheeler, bicycle, whatever it is. And for long-term goals, equity, which is like an aeroplane.
So Nikhil, would you like to explain how the power of compounding can really lead to prosperity in the short term or in the long term, and how it really works? Why investing even meager amounts on a monthly basis can really result in a large corpus by the time you retire?
So first of all, equity as a vehicle is never meant for short term. When you start a business, you don't start a business for 6 months or 1 year. You have a very clear visibility that I need to stay in the business for 5 years and 10 years, and then I'll create wealth for myself. The same applies for equities. Equity is nothing but I can't start a business, so I basically participate in someone else's business and be a part of the growth story, right? So equity is clearly meant for long term and never meant for short term. And now, what is the biggest vehicle what equity have? It's called something as power of compounding. We all have heard about Warren Buffett, right? So in terms of return, Warren Buffett has not given exorbitant return. His return is equivalent to if I take a Sensex return, right? So Sensex return is equal to what Warren Buffett has given in return. But what is the difference which Warren Buffett has made, because he's the second richest person in the world, and none of the Indian is the second richest person in the world? The reason is that he is able to compound his money. He started investing at the age of 14, right? And then he said, I've lost 14 years of my life by not investing. And by only doing this compounding benefit work for him, he is able to create that wealth. And how the compounding works? So normally what we say is that, okay, if I've invested, say, 1 lakh rupees, if I take a simple example of 12% return, in 6 years, the money gets double. So your 1 lakh in 6 years will become 2 lakh. So in that way, you say, okay, 1 lakh rupees banaya hai. But the next 6 years, it becomes 4 lakh rupees. So it's not only growth of 1 lakh, it's growth of another 2 lakhs more. And the next 6 years, the 4 becomes 8 lakh rupees. So this is where the magic of compounding comes in. Then you get interest on interest, right? So the idea is that in equity is that all about compounding. I don't see wealth created in the first 6 years or first 10 years. I normally see the wealth created after 10, 15 years because the magic compounding works. The 1 become 2, then the 2 become 4, and the 4 become 8. The last 6 years, the growth was 4 lakh rupees as compared to what you invested is only 1 lakh rupees. This is where the magic of compounding works.
Let's also talk a little bit about the various essentials in a portfolio that a youngster who's just starting out must have. And are there 3 or 4 or 5 broad categories that you can list out where, that covers maybe taxes as well, plus investments that you think would be essential for anybody who in the salaried class?
So the first goal is that you all should start planning for your retirement the day you start working. And for that, you need to invest in equity as an asset class. Second is that we have short-term goals, and which is called as a contingency planning in place, right? So we all have any MNC can come in. So this is where the call is contingency planning. So at any point of time, we should have our 6 months expenses in very, very liquid asset that I can withdraw this money at any point of time. And for that, we have one of the best instrument called as liquid funds, where you can withdraw your money at any point of time. Up to 50,000, you can withdraw instantly, and rest of the money comes to next day. So have a contingency planning in place, right? And third is what you call as a tax saving. Right, so we all are earning. There's a section called 80C, which government provides you tax benefit if you invest up to 1.5 lakh rupees. For majority of us, the EPF will take some portion of that, but remaining amount of money can be invested in equities, which can be linked to your retirement, which is called as ELSS schemes. Mm-hmm. So for youngsters, get a term insurance in place, health insurance in place, start having a contingency fund in place, start planning for retirement. Which you can start with ELSS and then gradually move to other asset classes.
All right. Okay. And on that note, we are going to head into a short break right now. But stay with us, because on the other side, our financial experts will continue to engage with the employees here at Tiger Logistics in New Delhi. You are watching Season 6 of NSE FinWiz, powered by CNBC TV 18. Welcome back to Season 6 of NSE FinWiz, powered by CNBC TV 18. We're at Tiger Logistics, New Delhi today, and our financial experts are here to engage with the employees and educate them about money management. Our core topic of discussion for today is how to plan your taxes while aiming for prosperity. This is the tax planning season. I'm sure everyone here, have you all already filed your investment papers or is it due sometime soon in the process? Okay, so I'm sure they're going to value all the advice you give them on where to put their money and really minimize their taxes. So first, let's start with a primer of sorts on what are the sections under which they can save taxes. What are some of the easy to do two or three investments that each one of them probably should be doing? Tanvir, would you like to start?
Okay, let me first ask you, how many of you start planning your taxes in the beginning of the financial year? Very good, quite a few of them. Okay, if you start planning at the beginning of the year, it's going to be far more productive. That's first thing there. You don't wait for the last quarter to come in. Inevitably, you rush and you try to tend to invest in product without actually looking into that. And hence, you make those blunders or mistakes. Two, insurance is not an investment. So you should buy insurance only for your life. It's an income replacement strategy and you should buy term insurance. So 80C is where it qualifies. So 80C, you get your normal EPF, you get your life insurance for the term insurance that you pay. And the third thing that you can actually look at thereafter is ELSS. The principal from home is also a part of that 80C bracket of 1.5 lakh. These are four critical which you could see easily. The other thing is 80D, which is nothing but your medical insurance. I would like to reiterate what Nikhil said. Even if you have a company provided medical insurance, please do buy your own term insurance. Okay. Another is NPS. Over and above the 1.5 lakh rupees, if you invest 50,000 rupees in NPS, you can plan your retirement. That gives another tax breaks to you beyond that 1.5 lakh rupees. These are simple things that you can do and save tax. Hence, in the new tax budget that's got rolled out, so if you have a salary of up to 5 lakh rupees, yes, and you can save this 2 lakh rupees as an additional thing, 7 lakh rupees is completely tax-free in your hands. So up to 7 lakhs, you can actually don't pay tax. These are the easy tax things that you can do.
Right. Nikhil, a lot of people also want to know, how do you really ensure that the money that you're saving with respect to taxes are not just... it's not just for saving tax, it's also working for you. So where do you put that money? What are the best avenues to make the money work for you while also saving taxes?
When we have to save taxes, it's only about saving taxes. But it's not only saving taxes. You have to do investments which also help you to save taxes. Right? So that's all the efficient planning. Okay. Now, the major section which comes in from a tax planning perspective, ATC and ATCCD, which is under ATC, we get tax benefit to 1.5 lakh rupees. And under ATCCD, we get an NPS of 50,000 rupees. Now, under ATC, you have various options. You have LIC policies, you have ELSS, you have PPF, you have EPF, right? So there are various options available to you. Now, if you are in highest tax bracket and if you don't have any debt investments to be done till now, then PPF is the best option for you. Because PPF gives you complete tax benefit. When you invest, you get tax benefit. All the interest which comes in PPF is a tax-free in your hands. And when you redeem the money and maturity, it's completely tax-free in your hands. So people who wants to invest in debt and who belongs to 30% tax bracket or 20% tax bracket, PPF is a very, very good option for you. So you should invest in PPF. If you are young and want to create wealth for long term, so then I'll say ELS is a far better option for you. Because ELS is similar to PPF. When you invest, you get tax benefit. And the only difference is that PPF invests all your money in debt, ELS invests all your money in equities. So if you're young and you want to create wealth, ELS is a far, far better option for you. Then comes NPS, which called New Pension Scheme. So what is New Pension Scheme? Over and above the 1.5 lakh rupees, you get additional benefit of 50,000 rupees. And if your company also starts an NPS, right, the company also can claim exemption. And up to 10% of your basic salary can also get tax benefit under that.
Right. Okay, let's then get the questions here that employees of Tiger Logistics have shared with us. The first one is from Khajan Singh Ulchai, who's a project senior manager projects here. And the question is, how to increase income in each month with prosperity goals? Can you increase income on a monthly basis by investing?
When you're saving money, and if you actually it's not so much important that picking the right set of fund. The example that I gave you of 10,000 rupees for the last 20 years, it was one of the best performing fund during that time. But today it's not one of the best performing fund. So it is the consistency that actually creates wealth of and the religious discipline. Now, if you want to have a six-pack or a very good physique, expecting it to have a good six-pack or a physique in few months and come 1 or 2 years is a little difficult. It is an effort of a consistent workout over the years, and that is what is the root cause of creating wealth.
All right. On that note, let's take another quick break right now. On the other side, the conversation will continue right here on NSE FinWiz, powered by CNBC TV 18. We are coming to you from the campus of Tiger Logistics in New Delhi today. Welcome back to Season 6 of NSE FinWiz, powered by CNBC TV 18. We are at Tiger Logistics today, and our set of financial experts is here to answer all the queries that the employees have here.
Me and my brother invested in an equity and commodity market. And I should say, literally, we burnt our hands as we lost 50% money from that. So that has actually scared us, and that is making us more conscious about investing more tactfully for our post-retirement life.
So did you invest in equity mutual fund or direct equity?
It was equity stocks, like stocks, shares. commodity share. Market.
Okay. Yeah. See, what is different between investing in a mutual fund versus investing in direct shares and stock? See, when you're investing, it's a game of probability. So when you're investing in a mutual fund where about 40-50 companies there, which is handpicked by a finance professional who does the research, the probability of that success is far higher. Okay. And if you look at the volatility also, it is little less. Now, as a layman, if you're trying to actually buy a stock without research, okay, so you are betting on a company which may not have the right probability of being successful. So if you pick a company which is not going to be successful, you are going to burn your hands. Okay. So hence it is makes sense to invest through an equity mutual fund, not through equity. Second question that you put out was commodity. Okay. So if you're trading in a commodity, trading across the world is extremely difficult. Why? Because when you're trading, you act emotionally. You are bound to go through that emotional turmoil. And when there is a loss that you see, you react very emotionally. And that is why people don't make money in trading.
Is it better? It is said that it's better to invest in a gold fund over physical gold. So how do you choose a good gold fund? In terms of rate of investment also, rate of return also, is it better than investing in physical gold?
Whenever you buy a gold from a bank, normally you pay a premium over gold prices. So you're buying at a higher price. When you buy from a jeweler, then there's a risk of purity, whether it's pure or not pure. So that's why people say that instead of buying a physical gold, it's far better to buy a demat gold, because there's no premium you're paying, and second, there's no purity problem. And third, the biggest benefit is that there's no storage problem. When you buy a gold in physical form, you don't know how to store it. Whereas in demat form, it can be easily stored. Now, even in demat form, there are a couple of ways how you can buy gold. One is basically go and buy a gold ETF, which is basically buy a mutual fund. Now, the good part to buy a electronic gold is something called sovereign gold bond, which is a far better alternative than an ETF also. Because an ETF fund manager charges you a small percentage of expense ratio to manage that gold. Whereas in sovereign gold bond, you can directly buy that from the government of India. Right? So there's no expense involved in that. Now, how these bonds are structured? Today, if say, for example, the gold price is 30,000 rupees, so the one bond is equal to 30,000 rupees. After 8 years, which is a tenure of the bond, so which basically after 5 years, you can start maturing. So 5, 6, 7, 8 is the time frame. So after 8 years, if the gold price is 60,000 rupees, one bond is equal to 60,000 rupees. So you get equivalent to bond prices. So bond prices is calculated in terms of gold prices. So you get similar return like a gold.
All right. With that, it's a wrap of this episode of NSE FinWiz on CNBC TV 18. Hope you enjoyed those money mantras and hope you'll put them to good use and move ahead on your path to prosperity. We'll be back next time with lots more. Thanks for joining us. Goodbye.
It was a quite learning experience for all of us. The way both experts given us a detailed detail of finance. and it was a quite learning experience.
This is my second session for FinWiz and it has been equally beneficial. Usually what happens, the daughters are usually kept away from this investment in the family. But after attending these sessions, I think that we should be equally aware and more interest, take interest understanding the working of the mutual funds, because usually we are just into traditional investments.
We had a good interaction with the industry experts and we really came up to the landed on the information on which area we need to invest, especially for the long-term investments.